See ya. Please welcome our next guest, a brother and sister team who play everything, bass, drums, guitar, piano, they do it all. Jamie and Justin Schultz. Hi family, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, good. So I want to tell everyone, I first met you all like 2 or 3 years ago?
Yeah, I think
Ty Tribbett.
Ty Tribbett.
2018. Yeah.
2018?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so I met you there. I didn't get a chance to play with you, but you were performing right before I was. And I saw the both of you play, and I was just like blown away. You have a gift. I mean, you can teach some of what you're doing, but you have a gift, and it's just amazing. It's incredible to see, and it's so inspiring, and I can't believe it. It's just amazing to be able to see that young people are playing real instruments. I love it.
Thanks so much. Thank you so much.
So I want you to, I guess, share with the people, you know, how you both got started and all that you play.
Okay, so my dad is a jazz guitarist, so we've constantly been around music since we were born, I guess.
Yeah.
So we would always go to his shows and rehearsals, and, you know, that's how we got into music.
And I always wanted to join his band, so that's how...
Yeah, so one day, for me, there was a keyboard in the house, and I just started doodling around, and I guess that's how it started.
When I was younger, I always used to like play on everything. So my dad eventually bought me a drum kit, and that's how I got started.
So you wanted to play drums first, Jamie?
Yep, I did.
You did, and then you started playing keyboards first, Justin?
Yes, keyboards first.
So how young were you?
I was 5, and you were
five.
Well, the thing is, it's crazy because my first performance with my dad, I was 5 years old. So wow. I understand, like, being 5 years old, I played on stage with my dad for the first time. I mean, I loved music, but I didn't know that this is what I was going to do. So how did the both of you then, your dad being a jazz guitarist, did he teach you different things? Because you both play everything, bass, drums, guitar, I mean, piano. I'm confused.
Yeah. Well, for me, I was playing piano for like 6 or 7 years before I picked up another thing, because the next instrument I picked up was talk box, and then I picked up guitar almost 2 years ago, and then bass this last year, and then harpeggi also. So,
harpeggi is amazing. Love that.
Yeah, it's really fun to play.
Yeah, I love playing it.
Yeah. And then what about you, Jamie?
I started playing drums at around 5, and then I picked up keyboard just a bit. I went for lessons and everything, but as soon as he started playing, I quit and just stick. And then I think 2017, I picked up bass, but then I stopped in 2019. And then during quarantine, I picked it up again because I have nothing to do.
Wow, well, that's a good thing to pick up, is having nothing to do and then learning how to play a 5-string bass. And, you know, yeah, wow. Okay, let me just try this. Wow, that is amazing. I can't even believe it. So how did you get to Durham? Where were you before? Because I met you in Orlando.
Yeah, so when we moved to the States, because we're originally from South Africa, so we moved here around 5 years ago, and then we moved to Michigan. And then from there, we went to North Carolina here. So that's how we ended up.
You're born in South Africa?
Yes, South Africa.
Oh, I didn't know that. Okay. Well, that I didn't know. There you go. See? Are your parents there now?
Yeah, my dad's actually here. He just walked in.
Hey, Sheila.
Hey, how you doing, man?
Good, and you?
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, too.
It's been a long time.
It's a crazy time.
Crazy time, I know. Yeah. During this pandemic, I haven't picked up anything new. Like, I didn't learn how to play a 5-string or, you know, just had... I started gardening and cooking. So that was just the two things I started doing.
When you cook, it's really entertaining.
Yeah. Yeah. Crispinizing.
Come on now. Say it one more time for the people.
Crispinizing.
Yes. That's it. You got to crispinize. See? That's right. So anyway, I wanted to know, like, what was the music scene where you guys grew up that you learned how to play music the way that you do?
So I'm a guitar player, and I had my own band from church, played in church all my life, and then started doing contemporary jazz, recorded three projects.
Three.
Was signed to Universal in 2012. That's when he started playing, and she started playing. She used to play, like, at my shows. I'd call her up to do a couple of songs at my shows, and she'd steal the crowd all the time. And then he started playing, and just one day, I put them together, and I'd call them up to do one song with me, right? And then a few times after that, the people that would book me would book them. Like, would book they would book me and say, we actually want your kid. So I would book my bass player, keyboard player, and drummer. And my band were not happy campers when that started.
Well, that's what my dad used to do. He used to bring us on stage and let us sit in with him. So I understand, like, the two of you playing together, well, all three of you, but the kids playing together, you know, you kind of grow up doing that. And it's a different chemistry than playing with someone else because you know each other. And tell me about that. How's it feel for you guys?
Well, it feels great because we have a great, offstage relationship at home and stuff. So that kind of goes on stage. So we just have a lot of fun.
And it makes it so much fun playing with him because we have so much fun together. So we can laugh in that while we play.
Yeah, you know, tease our faces, tease my faces.
And that's the thing. The music, it's supposed to be fun. Like, some people, you're serious about your craft and what you're doing and everything. But it's infectious when you're having fun off stage and then you bring it to on stage and you have fun with your siblings. Like, I know what that's like. And my brothers and with my dad, it's like we're always arguing about who's going to take the solo on what song. No, I'm playing drums on this song. No, I'm playing timbales on this song. So we're always arguing about, and I mean, it's fun, but, you know, like, who's going to take the solo and all that stuff. And to be able to play with each other, it's just a lot of fun. So I'm so happy to see this because there's not a lot of families, but when you do see a family that plays together, it's just pretty amazing. We love seeing you play. I'm so inspired by the both of you. You're just, I love it. I wake up in the morning, I do my prayer and do all my stuff and, you know, getting ready to have breakfast or something. Then I'll go on and look at, you know, social media and I'll find you to see what did you do today. I'm like, are you kidding me? What? Oh my God. I know, because of the thing that you just did when you went to Detroit. I mean, so who wrote the song that you were playing?
It was Do I Do by Stevie Wonder.
But
it was
his arrangement.
It was my arrangement. That's on my album, actually.
Okay, so let's plug the album.
Oh yeah, so the album is called Groove Kid, G-R-U-V Kid. Yeah, it's out on all digital platforms.
Yeah, that's awesome. Awesome. Well, thank you, family, so much for talking with me. I love you so very much. I want the fans to follow you, and I hope, you know, we get to see each other soon. And God bless you. And thank you for the inspiration every day.
Thanks so much.
Love you. Bye. Oh my God, they were amazing. Aren't you inspired? Because I am. They're incredible. And I'm so happy that I can call them family now. It's really amazing. Yay! So anyway, thank you so much for being with us today on Sheila E TV, and we'll see you next time. Thank you for our beautiful and amazing family coming in, Aaron and David Hodick, and Justin and Jamie Schultz. Thank you so much for being here on Sheila E TV. God bless you.
the street.